As 9-year-old Amos Olwech runs his daily 4-kilometer journey from home to school in Awelo sub-county, 30 kilometers away, 51-year-old Semi Ongote pays respect to her deceased husband. Although both are residents of Amolatar district, Ongote and Olwech do not know each other. However, they share a story of transiting from gloom to bloom. Amos Olwech and his friends enjoy a soccer game. They are pleasantly interrupted by a visitor. The visitor is Susanna Kello, Olwech's biological mother. Mother and son haven't seen each other in a long time. Amos was born out of wedlock. Unfortunately, his father died when he was a toddler, so he lived with his mother, Susan. A year and a half ago, Susan found love and married another man. In line with Langi culture, Amos was returned to his father's homestead. His stepmother could have none of that, and all hell broke loose. A community-based group of peer educators intervened.
We call the family to our office and the mother, plus the clan leaders there. So we mediate, we counsel them, so they accepted before the office that they are going to bring back the baby and all the properties.
30 kilometers away in Akuon sub-county, widowed Semi Ongote was nearly left homeless when her dead husband's family decided to sell off her home and land for his funeral expenses debt mounting up to 600,000 Uganda shillings. In desperation, she sought the intervention of Amolatar peer educators activists.
After we called them, we wrote a letter and we called them here. So we mediated together with the clan leaders, the LC, and we talked. So we give them a task to go and pay back that debt. So they went back, we give them 14 days. After 14 days, they come back with the money. They also write the memorandum of understanding that the land is now belongs to that widow.
Amolatar Peer Educators Activist is a community-based organization that was formed by the group of 25 volunteers trained as human rights advocates by Platform for Labor Action, PLA, a national civil society organization.
We help the community members on cases like land issues, domestic violence, debts, and others.
Platform for Labor Action was formed in response to the absence of an appropriate voice to address the rights of and issues facing marginalized workers, especially women, youth, and children such as Amos and Semi Ongote.
We want a society where democratic values and social justice are respected. Okay? Our mission is that the community members out there, they are sensitized that they have rights as workers and that their rights ought to be respected.
Through interventions such as community outreach, legal aid, advocacy for human rights, mediation in land wrangles, and between employees and employers, addressing actions against child exploitation and neglect, the impact of PLA is far-reaching in the district.
I would say that there is a tremendous improvement. Because now, people know where to go to when they have problems. At least they are aware that if there is an issue that affects